and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a Los Angeles-bound commuter train slammed into a tractor-trailer truck, apparently stuck on the tracks in a Southern California city before dawn on Tuesday, injuring 50 people in a fiery crash, four of them critically. The truck driver, who was not hurt, left the scene of the destruction on foot and was found walking and talking on a cell phone in some sort of distress more than a mile and a half away. Assistant Police Chief Jason Benitez said Jose Alejandro Sanchez Ramirez was taken into custody on felony hit-and-run charges for leaving the scene of the accident. While no one was killed, the force of the impact overturned three double-decker Metrolink rail cars and derailed two others, ripped the truck apart, and left burning chunks of twisted wreckage still smoldering hours later. Benitez said it appeared that the truck driver, who was towing a trailer full of welding equipment, had taken a wrong turn in the pre-dawn darkness and ended up on the tracks, where the rig became stuck and the train approached at 79 miles per hour. Benitez declined to say what led police to arrest Sanchez Ramirez, other than that he had left the scene of the accident. He said the driver had undergone unspecified tests at a hospital and that investigators were looking into the possibility of drugs or alcohol being involved in the crash. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Retail giant CVS is gearing up for floods of customers seeking the perfect meaningless piece of crap for their office gift swap. The company is making no secret that when it comes to wasting the obligatory $20 on a useless electronic dartboard or pretzel maker for someone you couldn't care less about, CVS is your best option.
Our incredible selection of worthless shit is just the thing that nobody wants. We guarantee you'll find nothing personal or unique in our store.
The company is offering massive discounts on otherwise unsellable items for holiday parties you don't even want to go to, like the $12 decorative lantern, which is expected to be a big hit with customers who grab the first thing they see when they walk in the store.
I really wanted to get something that said, I don't care about any of you people and I didn't put any effort into this.
CVS also has shitty Hanukkah gifts for coworkers who you think might be Jewish, like candles and those little plastic net bags full of chocolate money.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind on this live edition of Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
855-450-3733. And you can call us on Skype. A lot of times the audio is better if you call on Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. You just send us a request, and sometime, hopefully as quickly as we can, we'll click on it and approve it, and then you can call in and, you know, should sound better. You know, doesn't always work that way.
Unless you have a terrible microphone.
Yeah. 855-450-3733. Well, it looks like some Republicans from the House of Representatives are threatening to throw D.C. mayor and other officials, Muriel Bowser, and other officials in jail if they allow marijuana to be legalized this evening.
I think it's at midnight.
Midnight tonight?
That's what I thought tomorrow. Ian said when he was in the other room.
This is always the problem with midnight as a cut.
Yeah.
You're never exactly sure which one it is. Is it the end of the day or the beginning of the day?
Just
midnight?
Tell me it's 12:01 a.m. at this day.
I say screw 'em, smoke it anyway. We're going to go to your calls. Talk to Uber George is calling in. George,
hey guys. I just received two letters from TSA. Get this, they sent me a certificate thanking me for 10 years of service. Never mind that I have not worked for them for over a year now, and I've actually worked for them 11 years, and they sent me this certificate of appreciation certificate thing.
So
it took them.
They canned you and then sent you a certificate thanking you for the 10 years of service you'd served on your 11th anniversary of the start?
Just over 1 year that I quit.
Okay.
And I worked for them 11 years, 4 months, 8 days.
All right.
And I just thought that I was like so retarded that it took them this long to send me something that says, thank you for working 10 years, which means it's been like well over two years since my 10th anniversary, I guess. And the other one was from the Italian government. Saying that they want $40 for some violation that they won't even say what right there when I was in Pisa.
Hold on. The Italian government is asking for $40 for some kind of violation level offense that they're not clear as to what it was when you were in Pisa.
I got actually from the rental car company called SAXD there. Here also in the U.S., like six, I think it was pronounced sixth, but anyway, yeah, it's like I get this thing saying like, yeah, you've been sent a violation here, you know, that we received, I was in Italy back in August,
so 8 months or something, seven,
six, yeah, something like that. But yeah,
well, they could just as easily be the rental car company that that's being bureaucratic too. Difficult for them to sort of know. But nobody's telling you what you supposedly have done.
Yeah, it doesn't say what I've done. And the letter I got, I'm looking at it. Oh no, okay, this is not an invoice. This is just a notice from the rental car company saying that the Italian government, I can expect something in the mail from the Italian government, which I'm going to ignore that because this is not the first time a foreign government sent me a letter demanding money. A few years ago, I got a letter from Australia. I think I remember calling you guys about it, saying that their speed camera caught me going 8 kilometers an hour, which is 5 miles an hour in U.S. measurements over the speed limit. And I was in Adelaide, and they wanted $235 for that.
Wow, that's pretty good. That's a lot of money for a 5 mile an hour over the limit.
Come and get me.
I'll tell you what, that's one of the advantages of a human police officer is it's unlikely that they're going to give you a ticket for going 5 miles an hour over.
Yeah, he's like, I'll wait for the next one. I'm going to get me some money today.
Yeah.
It's good. Exactly. Speed cameras, like, just like, I can get them all.
So, first off, obviously you're not going to be in any big trouble from the Italian government for an unpaid $40 violation, especially you never even know if you're going to go back.
Exactly. Same thing with Australia. It's like, really? It's like, what are they going to do? Extradite me on the way across either the Atlantic or, in Australia's case, the Pacific?
That's what they should do is that everybody who visits Italy should just get some kind of $40 level violation, and they can see how many of them will pay, and it's just free money.
It's just fishing.
Yeah. Just free money.
Yeah, pretty much on that thing. But I really don't hope I don't get banned from renting from Sixth again like it did from Thrifty, because Sixth gave me the best rental deal of my life when I was in Vegas back in October.
What about, so what happened with Thrifty?
Well, this happened about 15 years ago. I was working for Papa John's before I went to TSA. And we had a Thrifty rental car location right next to our shop. In exchange for free pizzas, they would let me, the manager there would let me rent a car for a day or something like that. Like, they had this Mustang Cobra that, for some, I don't know why, a rental car company.
Okay, get on with it. And what?
Yeah, so I gave them a pizza. He let me rent the Mustang Cobra for a day right there.
Uh-huh.
But then corporate finds out about that. And they fired him, and then they banned me for life because I was under 25.
Oh, I see. So it was because you're under 25. Gotcha.
Yeah, it's not like that. It's not like I brought the car back broken or scratched or anything like that. No, they want to. They banned me for life because I was under 25. And not only that, I can't even rent for dollar because dollar is the same. Dollar and 50 are not the same on that sense.
There you go. But thanks for the call, George. I appreciate it. 855-450-3733. Yeah, I one time got a parking ticket in D.C. I wasn't going to pay it. My mother actually saw the parking ticket. I'm living in Florida at the time. There's nothing the DC can do to me. She saw the parking ticket and paid it because she didn't want whatever the ramifications might be. She didn't want it to come down on me. I don't think it's going to be any big deal with a violation like that.
Probably not. I know I've gotten some tickets in New York City that they just never came after. So
let's go to Bob calling in from Florida. Bob, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
It's funny you mention that, because I called the revenue collectors about this parking ticket I got a couple months ago, and they told me that if I don't pay it, nothing will happen. They don't have collections in my city, and that nothing would come after my license. You know, driving is a privilege after all.
So yeah, that's
weird. I gotta make sure I placate that.
I love the privilege that, okay, so they take money from you to build the roads through property taxes and things like that. And then once they build the road with your money, they tell you it's a privilege for you to drive on the road. Now, I'm not saying that I think everybody in the world's qualified to drive, by no means am I. But I don't think that many of the people who don't have driver's licenses that choose to drive anyway are fine drivers. So I don't know that their whole licensing thing really, it's a bad
system. I imagine that a lot of the people who are driving without a license today are probably better drivers than most of the ones who do have driver's licenses, right?
I don't know.
Because we've got no shortage. Well, for one, they don't want to get caught, and two, in a lot of those cases, it's because they were caught doing something that was perfectly normal that they knew they could do because they were experienced drivers. They were driving fast or something to that effect, and there's, you know, people who are not terribly talented drivers will probably drive a little bit slower than people who are very skilled at it.
I can tell you, I'm from Florida myself, Bob, and there's a lot of people driving late model Lincolns and Buicks out there that have no qualifications to be on the road any longer.
We have a silver alert. That is, you know, there's the amber alert, and there's a silver alert to look out for elderly people who have escaped from their facilities. It's all kidding aside, something for people with Alzheimer's and that kind of thing.
Ageist.
But you know what, guys? Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
We're just teasing you.
Yeah, so I called, and I have an agenda. I'll be perfectly honest.
I'm too. An
activist myself, and I'm a talk radio host myself. I have a nationally syndicated talk show.
You have a nationally syndicated talk show. Awesome.
I do. My name's Bob Tuscan. I'm an activist. I have a conference we're holding in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, you want to buy advertisements, you can do that.
Go on,
no,
Bob.
I don't need to buy advertisements, but I was setting the stage for my comments.
Yes.
Let's not be rude, Christopher Cantwell.
Well, that's what he does for a living. So, tease it, Bob. Show us what a pro you are. You got 10 seconds to tease it.
When we come back in just a moment, we are going to take on the divide between the libertarian movement and crazy conspiracy theorists.
Hold the line. 855-450-FREE. Bob is going to bring us back in. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
I have two cats and two dogs. All four of them are on the Dynavite. This stuff is amazing. The first day that I gave Sweet Pea and Daisy the Dynavite for cats, I did add a little bit of the Lick-A Chops, and they absolutely loved it. All the vitamins, the minerals, you know, they also enjoyed the num-nums, the nub-nubs or whatever they're called, the treats that also came along with it.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
They're just running through the house. They're playing. My Sweet Pea will walk in front of me. She'll stop where she's at, drop and roll onto her back, and then expect me to rub her belly, just like a kitten. Daisy and Poopy have a cat tree in my living room, and lately she's been climbing up to the top, jumping up there, and then she'll climb back down, and then she's right back up again. Oh, I'm sorry. I wish they would make a product for us humans to give us the same amount of energy and gunk that Dynavite for cats are given for my cats. The phone number is 859-428-1000.
859-428-1000. DINOVITE.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
Now, I can understand why some people would look at what the mainstream environmental movement says and does and advocates and come to the conclusions that, well, some of these people seem to want humans to go back into caves.
They do.
But that's not to say that just because the most vocal environmental activists out there
are socialist nut jobs
are that way means that, we should just forget about taking care of the environment. Who wants pollution? Who wants any of that stuff? Right. What I want is market-based solutions that don't involve threatening violence against people, and that's what the government solution always is. The government doesn't persuade. The government doesn't ask. The government demands. And if you don't go along with their demands, they've got a nice cold concrete cage waiting for you.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Should you be able to earn an honest living free from senseless government interference? The Institute for Justice thinks so. That's why we've spent years defending hard-working men and women from pointless government regulations. Nationwide, IJ has created opportunity by reducing government power. But there is still more work to be done. Visit our website today at ij.org. Let IJ take care of the government so you can take care of your business.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can call us and talk about whatever is on your mind this evening. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
From ChristopherCantwell.com. Cantwell, thanks for sitting in with me this evening.
I'm so glad to.
And Ian is our normal first seat host. This is his night off. So thanks for filling in as you do so often. I want to tell you about Cameron Hughes Wines. We recently got a box of wines from Cameron Hughes. We had a little wine tasting so everybody could try it. I wanted to get lots
Not
of people.
Not everybody.
I you weren't invited?
No.
Well, I'm sorry.
Oh, wait. There was the wine tasting next door.
Yes.
Okay, that's what that was. Okay. Never mind. I was invited.
Okay, you were invited. You just didn't go.
Yeah, carry on.
It was awesome, and they were delicious. These are high-end wines, $70 to $100 bottles. Many of them have been rated over 90 points. People who drink wine, you know, high-end wines probably know what that means, but I can tell you that they're high-end wines, and they taste great. Cameron Hughes has actually gotten awards for some of his cabs, received gold medals. That's a Cabernet Sauvignon. You can get these bottles for like $15. So you're talking about, you know, $100 bottle of wine, $50. Anywhere between $50 and $100. What they are is they're the high-end wine manufacturers out there. I don't know if you call them wineries, whatever. They're wines that they, you know, they can't sell it all at that high-end price. He goes in, he buys the overage, he puts it in bottles with different labels, and you get these great high-end wines. You don't necessarily know from where, but they're awesome. So it's a great way. I'm hooked on this. I think it's awesome, and you should try it out too. Just go to chwines.com. It's chwine.com. chwine.com, and then enter my coupon code in with the microphones in the upper left there. Enter my coupon code FTL, and you're going to be getting free shipping. That's really the big deal with getting wine shipped through the mail, is it costs a lot. Wine's heavy. So
yeah.
That's the deal he made with us, and I think it's really awesome. I got a chance to talk to Cameron myself, and it's great. He's doing great work. So get free shipping by entering my coupon code FTL at chwines.com. The microphone's in the upper right-hand corner. Don't wait. You need to try this wine now. It's amazing, and this offer really will not last. chwine.com, coupon code FTL. Let's go back to Bob, who's calling in to talk about the divide amongst, is it conspiracy theorists and libertarians, Bob?
Yeah, I would say that that's the focus of my call today, because we know that many libertarians have fallen into the category of conspiracy theorists at one point or another.
I think everybody's a conspiracy theorist, by the way. I'm willing to go out on the limb and say Rush Limbaugh spends most of his day talking about conspiracy theories. Now, they're not conspiracy theories like 9/11 was an inside job. They're conspiracy theories like, I know those Democrats like every inch of my glorious naked body. Claims to know what other people are talking about, what their plans are. Talk radio is rife with conspiracy theories.
And I would agree with that. And I guess we have to define conspiracy theories and conspiracy theorists for a moment. And a conspiracy is just more than one person deciding to do something.
Yeah.
And then there's a connotation, though, that we have today that I'm referring to, which revolves around people that think there was something else that happened on 9/11 when they watch Building 7 fall in free fall speed at 5:20 in the afternoon. You know, those types that also look in the sky and they see barium, aluminum, and other aerosols being sprayed on a daily basis. That's what I mean by conspiracy theories.
Okay.
Or theorists, right?
I gotcha.
So for the purpose of this conversation, we'll go with that definition, and if it's all right with
Don't forget the Wawa machine in Alaska that they recently turned off. The HARP was spelled with two A's.
Yes, HARP. Yeah, but HARP's not the new thing. It's all the scalar technology.
Oh, I'm not even familiar.
You know, HARP's kind of the old-fashioned technology. Now we have even far more advanced scalar technologies.
Gotcha.
And space beams that were also behind directed energy weapons that were also behind 9/11. That
what the hell else would it be besides space beams, for God's sake?
Well, thermite. We have thermetic material, peer review data from Stephen Jones that showed
we got
thermetic
the idea.
Material was found. So the idea that there's a divide, though, between libertarians and conspiracy theorists is, I think, pretty darn apparent to anybody who's listening. And we have guys like Chris Cantwell, who's on with you, who have shunned his former colleagues and compadres in the conspiracy movement and has come out to say that he has basically been reformed, and he no longer believes these things that were at one point.
It depends on which particular conspiracy theory you're talking about. I don't know that I've changed my position on a whole lot of these things. How much time I spend on them is another question. I've never been a big fan of the whole chemtrail thing. I don't believe for a moment that the government is telling us the truth about 9/11, but I don't know that George Bush did it with a remote control either. So, I mean, I try to find the reality of the matter instead of delving down crazy rabbit holes and listening to Alex Jones until I mess my pants and hide in a bunker.
Well, I think a proper thought process is important here, because we have to be agnostic thinkers and not poo-poo something because on the surface it fits into a category of conspiracy Alex Jones-related content. And I think that's what libertarians at the end of the day should embrace, because at the end of the day, being a libertarian is an agnostic perspective on rights, on natural law, and everything else.
I would agree with you on that statement. I think that different people can come to different conclusions. And one thing that people are going to say is there's a lot of people who've been brought to the liberty movement by the conspiracy theorists. What do you say to that, Bob?
I would agree, and vice versa for that matter. And we see, in many respects,
I would also say that it's uncountable how many people have been scared away from the libertarian philosophy by whatever they perceive as the coupling of conspiracy theories and libertarianism. So it's difficult.
I would agree that that's so. However, just because that is the case, that should not mean you guys should placate to the lowest common denominator, because many people are turned off by libertarian perspectives for a plethora of different reasons.
Generally, yeah.
So to say that because people are turned off because of conspiracy rhetoric being espoused by some libertarians, that shouldn't necessarily bring you to the conclusion that we should exclude that sort of talk.
Oh, I don't think that I would say that what we do on Free Talk Live is I don't take a stance on 9/11 generally. When I talk about 9/11, I will use the sort of mainstream talking points because that's what I believe the vast majority of people believe. But I don't know that that's the case. I would say that, you know, that I'm generally anti-chemtrails.
We had a guy on here, we had a guy call in last week. He lives next to a military base. And, of course, you know, hey, there's an Air Force base. There's jets flying away from the place, and he's concerned that there are lines in the sky. And I'm like, well, you know, considering where you live, it stands to reason that you might have some lines in the sky.
Well, I think that this conversation could definitely go into many different tangents. And I, by all means, think that there is a plethora of information and evidence to show that barium, aluminum, and strontium is being sprayed in these persistent contrails that act very differently than contrails.
No, there isn't. There's absolutely none at all. It's not. There are people who are picking up soil samples and concluding that this is what came from the sky. And it's just, it's not. The chemtrail thing makes me go crazy. I
like ContrailScience.com, and I remember contrails sticking around, you know, when I was a kid, too. Bob, I encourage you to continue calling Free Talk Live over time, and I thank you for this call. Thank you so much. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit. Bitbit.co. Why? Because Bitbit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoin by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at Bitbit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer Bitbit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start to today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at bitbit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. Bidbit.co.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait.
You wanna count.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of 5 $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403, 800-872-0403, 800-872-0403.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You want to call in, talk about whatever's on your mind this evening. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
You can go get Bitcoins at expresscoin.com. If you've been hearing about Bitcoins, maybe you realize that Bitcoins are pretty competitively priced. You know, they're about half price what they were just a few months ago. Now may be the time to pick up some Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. And actually, they have several other cryptocurrencies over there at expresscoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. You can just go over there, use a check or a money order. It's expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you. You can even do it from your smartphone. They've got an app. It's awesome when your business has an app. Expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you can get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of your choice with no fee. Now, obviously, they're going to charge you for the coins, but there's no fee for the transaction. So it's expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. Definitely worth checking out. And, you know, I am still bullish on Bitcoins. I've seen the price increase recently. I don't know whether there's going to be some kind of stampede, but what I think is amazing about Bitcoin is there's so many people, so many very smart people creating so many businesses and services around Bitcoin that, you know, but we use an app or a program called Telegram, and now it's called Telebit that you can send Bitcoin.
I just
through.
Discovered that today myself, and I also think that there's a huge potential for it. I mean, it had been around $200, then it spiked up over $1,200, which was an obvious, you know, speculative bubble in my book.
It wasn't even that. It was some trickery through Mt. Gox of their buying and selling robots. So
Well, and then what happened after that was then it came back down to around like 600, and it was stayed there for a little while, but then it dropped back down to around 200, and now it's inching back up. And that's the return to mean that you look for after a speculative bubble. It's back to the point where it's climbing.
Let's go to Jonathan calling in from South Carolina. Jonathan, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Oh, I was just calling in to defend the conspiracy theorists, and I've heard that y'all didn't like the chemtrail part.
I just can't believe that every single contrail that's in the sky is a chemtrail.
Okay, I mean, I wouldn't say that at all.
What
but,
percentage?
You know, over the past year, I don't know what percentage.
When was the last time you saw a contrail?
You know, I took some pictures of a contrail next to a chemtrail when I was at the park with my kid.
Okay, when was that?
Probably two weeks ago.
Okay.
And you could very clearly see where the contrails were. I was going to actually make something and post it up online, you know, like how we used to, you know, we used to see animals in the sky, or we would play with our imagination with our parents, and, you know.
Oh, the clouds, you mean?
Huh?
The clouds would be the shape of animals? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. The clouds.
When I was younger, I spent more time looking at the sky, that's for sure.
Yeah, so, but, you know, now, like, because you can see these things crisscrossing the sky.
Yeah, it's true that you do see them crisscrossing, there's no doubt about it.
Especially when you live near airports and Air Force bases, it's sort of expected.
We had a pilot call in, and it's been probably a couple of years.
Close to an airport.
Okay.
But one thing I was going to say, I just want to get this out real quick, is that within the past year, and back as early as 2011, 2012, Bill Gates was talking about geoengineering.
Yes, geoengineering is a buzzword in the sort of the climate change sphere, and I think that it's clear, right? Like, some people are thinking about what can we do to planet Earth in order to stop the warming trend that they believe they see.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, we've had more ice expansion on the poles since 2006, when all of the scientists were predicting that, you know, we
were
going
to be heading. That's an entirely different conversation.
Right. I get that there are global warming fanatics out there who actually believe it, and then I get there are people who know that they are lying about it. What I don't get is where you come up with the idea that commercial airliners are drawing shapes in the sky in order to spray stuff on the population. If they wanted to put things in the air, they don't need to put it in American Airlines, in the back seat of the American Airlines jets to spray it. And it doesn't need to be left in a line. You're like the same things I've been seeing since I'm a child.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that they're putting chemicals into, you know, American Airlines.
That's precisely what you're saying.
No, that is not what I'm saying. You're not even listening to me. What I'm saying is that Bill Gates is on the record. He has been in the news to support geoengineering.
Yeah, geoengineering has nothing to do with lines in the sky. I've seen a report from a government agency just came out about geoengineering.
How do you think that they're talking about, you know, reflecting some of that sunlight back into the sky?
Well, they've got all kinds of plans. If you read about geoengineering, there's all kinds of plans that are laid out. I mean, they're not I have seen very little that has to do with dropping stuff out of airplanes. And if they were doing it, why wouldn't they just tell us? Why wouldn't they just say, yeah, the world, the globe is warming and we have to do something about it or we're all going to die. Look at the poor polar bears. Why wouldn't they just go ahead and do it?
I think they are telling us with Bill Gates coming out and talking about owning a $40 million geoengineering firm. ABC.
$40 million is nothing.
It's more than I got.
Well, it's more than I have, too.
If they're giving Bill Gates $40
million
to start
a drop in the bucket. You know, I agree with you on that.
But it doesn't explain. Look, the thing is, if you're not saying that it's American Airlines, I mean, look, the thing that happens is, and it's always the guy who lives near the airport is always screaming about chemtrails the most. I worked right around the corner from an airport, and my buddy was a total conspiracy kook. And he would say, look, when are we going to do something about these chemtrails? What are we going to do something? And you never seen a contrail before, it seems. It's a thing that happens all the time. There's lines in the sky. The fact that they crisscross just means that two airplanes went in perpendicular directions. Is that the right term? Perpendicular? They cross each other? That's parallel would be. Yeah, perpendicular. And then they crossed paths at two different times, and now there's lines in the sky, and this is happening with commercial airliners. So if you're not saying it's, you know, commercial airliners, if you're not saying it's, you know, American Airlines, then who's putting all these lines in the sky?
Maybe geoengineering firm.
Well, let me ask you this, Jonathan. I think this is important. Okay, wait, this is an important question I have for you.
Maybe they're doing it to help cool the planet.
So where are the pictures of these planes? Now, these pilots who are spraying down whatever they're spraying are spraying it on their families, right? I mean, that's what they're doing. They're spraying it on their kids, and they're spraying it on their wife, and they're spraying it on their dog. You'd think that one of them somewhere would have leaked a picture at some point of this setup, because you'd have to have a lot of stuff shoved into a large plane in order to spray it all over the place and get yourself a nice long
chemtrail. You can go to 100 places online, and I'm not saying that any one of them is credible, but you can go to 100 different chemtrail activist places online that will sit there and they'll show you pictures.
I can go to 100 different places.
Leaked and, you know, like, well, I don't really think that that's a valid argument.
Well, the valid, you don't think that finding people that would, there's people poisoning us, those people have families, somebody, well,
yeah,
okay, so here's a valid argument, Jonathan. Show me some freaking proof. Jonathan, that's what my argument is. You need to present unassailable truth if you're making a claim. At this point, all I can see is contrails like I've seen my whole life.
Okay, well, I mean, you know, when I look up at the sky, I can tell the difference between a contrail and a chemtrail.
You've seen two different types of contrails.
Do what?
You're seeing two different types of contrails, different age. Different jets have different quality. Contrails are just water that's coming out of the back of a jet engine, and different engines provide different types of contrails.
I understand what a contrail is, and, you know, by no means do I go on the extremist side of the conspiracy theory with this and think that they're, you know, like what you're saying with these pilots would be spraying it on their kids and their wives and their families and all of that stuff. Well, I don't think that they're actually spraying the actual chemicals that all these, the crazy conspiracy theorists would say with the aluminum alloys, stuff like that. Well,
how do you explain strontium in the soil?
Thanks for the call. I appreciate it, Jonathan. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Call about something other than chemtrails.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in, talk about whatever is on your mind this evening. It's been one of Cantwell's favorite topics.
I despise chemtrails.
Well, I'll tell you what.
And I'm not talking about, like, I'm angry about the lines in the sky. I mean, I despise that people call in here with these crazy, non-backed up ideas that they're like, I live by the airport and they're crisscrossed and I swear they're gonna kill us all. They're trying to geoengineer the planet. And I'm like, look, I'm sorry to tell you folks, I've looked into the things that you asked me to look into and it's nonsense. And every time we try to get into it, they're like, oh, well, there's hundreds of websites that you could go, yeah, exactly. There's hundreds of websites I can go to look at that tell me that communism's a really good idea too. It doesn't mean that they're credible. Come on. If you have something, then call in with something. Don't tell me what you saw on What in the World Are They Spraying or some G. Edward Griffin documentary. It's nonsense.
Well, you can go to demo.freetalklive.com, and that will be a good use of your online time because I'm giving away three $50 gift certificates to Corporate Sellout Clothing. It's T-shirt manufacturer. They got some cool stuff on their T-shirts. I think you'll enjoy it. Is all you have to do is fill out my survey at demo.freetalklive.com. Just make sure you give me your email address. You can't win if you don't give me the email address. You can still fill it out. It's an optional as far as giving the email address, but just saying, can't win otherwise. I'm going to do that drawing on March the 1st at noon Eastern. International winners can win. International listeners can win, but you're going to probably have to cover shipping because, you know, it can be pretty expensive to get it out to Bora Bora or wherever. It's demo.freetalklive.com to enter and fill out the survey. Let's go to Nick, calling in from Ohio. Nick, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Don't you dare say chemtrails.
No, I promise I have something that is more, a little bit more intellectual than that. I can promise.
Okay. Thank you.
I'm interested to hear your guys' opinion on this because I've heard some sort of left market libertarians who have sort of weird views on adverse possession, and I was wondering what your official line on that was.
You're going to tell me what adverse possession
is? Is that absentee ownership?
Yeah, so adverse possession is the doctrine by which an absentee owner loses the deed to his property if somebody else comes and attempts to homestead it.
I think this is fascinating.
For a certain period of time.
I think it's a fascinating question. So first off, I've got a couple of sort of caveats. I have more questions than I have answers around this idea. I would say that about 70% of the globe is essentially unowned currently because it's covered in water. And so there's a great deal of area where you could potentially put seasteads and that sort of thing. So you could go out and there's places that one could be and stuff that one could
And there's a great deal of land owned by governments illegitimately.
Indeed. They don't have the greatest and best of land, but nonetheless. So there's that. But I think that, like, for instance, what if I own a little piece of property and I decide at my death, you know what, I want this property to be given to the Audubon Society so that it will be returned to nature and people can hike here and enjoy it from, you know, for posterity. And then you have this organization like the Audubon Society that has a bunch of land all over. Some of it's given by, you know, towns that basically you don't know what to do about the property taxes and that sort of thing. They don't want to manage it. And, I mean, it has a purpose, right? Like, the purpose is that it can be hiked on and that sort of thing. So how does that fit into the scenario? I can see how we say, well, there's you know, one family that owns 90% of the planet. We must be able to dispossess them of that land so the rest of us can get off the 10% or something like that. I get the concept, but usually it has to be taken to ludicrous extremes to even have the discussion. Nick?
Okay, yeah. No, that makes sense. I just, like, this seems to be something that is kind of a point of debate between a lot of libertarians, where you have people, like, extreme left libertarians, like, you know, anarcho-communists.
Georgists.
Who say that...
There's another term, Georgist, people that believe that all the land can't be owned and that we need an organization that sort of that everybody pays land taxes to, and then that organization distributes all the money out to everyone to sort of equalize the use of land or something.
Right,
and in in practice, what that means, of course, because the Central Committee is incredibly inefficient, what that would mean in practice is that the minute you stop using something, somebody else can come use it and claim it.
Right. I mean, right? I've gone back and forth recently. I was actually, it's interesting you bring this up, because I was just trying to listen to the audiobook Markets Not Capitalism. And
who's that by?
That is by a series of authors from the Center for a Stateless Society. And the audiobook is actually read, I was surprised to find, by Stephanie Murphy, who's was a co-host of this program. And that mess is just anti-capitalist word salad. I'm furious trying to get through the book. But I have already responded to one portion of it, which was Anarcho-Capitalism is Impossible by Anna Morgenstern over at Center for a Stateless Society. You can read that if you want. The title of my response is Left Anarchism is Impossible over at ChristopherCantwell.com. And they basically don't believe in absentee ownership, right? That basically this is a bad thing, that somebody holds a title over some land that they are not presently in control of. They feel like at some point somebody should be able to. Well, we all believe in, I think most people believe in abandoned property to some extent. The question is, how long is it before that property is considered abandoned? If Mark goes down to Acapulco tomorrow for Anarchapulco, does he like lose his house when he gets on the airplane? I mean, it's a question of at what point does the property become abandoned? And there's certainly, you know, a lot of room for debate in that.
This happens all the time. There was a situation in Sarasota, Florida that I heard about. I mean, I don't know what the specifics are, but I mean, I'd heard about it. It was like a condominium that they were going to build. A bunch of people sort of bought in, and the condominium never got built. Well, essentially, this condominium had this piece of land had 40 or 50 or 100 owners or whatever the number was, and they could never agree on selling it, so that it was just this sort of undeveloped piece of land on, you know, in one of the richest zip codes in America that just kind of sat there, and people, you know, people to a lesser or greater extent suffered as a result.
The ultimate answer to this is just the physics. The reality of it is you own something for as long as you're capable of protecting it. Okay, so if Mark decides to go down to Anarchapulco and he lives in a stateless society, he's probably going to want to hire somebody to watch over that land. Right now, that agency is the state.
I'm going to do that anyway.
Okay. yeah, I mean, I was just wondering, does the whole notion of property rights and does the whole market break down if you can't have absentee ownership?
Because if you can't have absentee ownership, then there's chaos, right? But what we know from just the reality on the ground about property is you have something for as long as you're capable of protecting it. Even if you have the right to something, like, look, if I walk down to Central Square after the show tonight and I decide to have a beer at the gazebo and I leave my wallet on the gazebo and I go home, I don't think that anybody has the right to take my wallet and go spend my money, but I better expect that they will, is the reality of the matter. So I am in control of my money for as long as I am capable of protecting it. So in the terms of absentee ownership, as I see it in a future stateless society, you are going to hire somebody to protect your property while you are not at it. And those people are going to act as the agents thereof and handle it. And when you can no longer pay for your property to be protected, right or wrong, somebody else will take it.
Right. I think it's interesting. I have a piece of land that likely was occupied by some Abenaki Indians at one point. And so I would say that they sort of have some kind of claim, you can call it legitimate or not, on that piece of land. Cuba's a really great example because there are people alive today whose property is being lived in by other people because they were driven out of the communist country. So it's this difficult situation, and I think you're absolutely right that ultimately we have to kind of come to, you know, what does this mean? I think that the thief is responsible for paying you back if they steal something from you, but ultimately, you know, they're responsible for making you whole. But, you know, there's all the gold in the world. How much of the gold in the world that currently exists was stolen from somebody else? That stuff's been around a long time.
Right. And then where the guy who got his gold stolen, does his grandchildren come after you because you have a piece of metal that was melted down and forged into something else, and then it's on your neck? I mean, it's a conundrum that you can get into.
Yeah, right. Well, thanks, guys. Anyway, I have to go, but thank you for
that.
Thank
you, buddy.
Sorry to keep you, buddy. 855, 453. You know, I think libertarians love to wrestle with these sort of mind problems, but property is something that is built into the human human sort of psyche. It's animals have it. Now, ultimately, they don't know what's yours. Well, you know, that's not even true. When an animal goes on to into another animal's territory, it tends to lose. Even a bigger animal that's wants to fight, it tends to lose because it doesn't feel comfortable. It doesn't know the terrain. It just it doesn't feel like it's it. It belongs to them. I think property is sort of innate. I do believe in sort of a natural law, and I think that natural law says that, yeah, people can travel across your property as long as they don't harm anything, but it's still your property. 855-450-FREE. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. 855-450-3733.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,206, down $3. Silver opened at $16.53, down 11 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $238. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? For a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss this unique opportunity. To sign up and get your 1 month cost-free advertising gift, just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. In the news, an investigation by The Guardian has revealed the Chicago Police Department has been using a warehouse as a black site to illegally hold suspects without access to family, attorneys, and where they're subject to beatings. The facility is located in Chicago's Holman Square and has been used as a workstation for special police units. The Guardian interviewed lawyers and former detainees who revealed several facts, including detainees being kept out of official arrest databases, shackled for extended periods of time, and denied access to attorneys for 12 to 24 hours. Some suspects were as young as 15 years old. One man was found unresponsive while at the facility's interview room. He later died. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, each day this week, the Liberty Beat is bringing you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. Here's John Bush.
Own firearms and know how to use them safely and proficiently. Purchase a shotgun and handgun and learn to use them in defense of your home. Acquire a rifle and learn to shoot with accuracy in defense of your family and property. It helps to learn from a friend or family member or take a course in self-defense and firearm safety. Firearms are a very serious tool as they have the ability to take a person's life. Always practice the four firearm safety rules. Number one, always act as if your weapon is loaded. Number two, be aware of your target and what lies behind your target. Number three, always keep your finger off the trigger until you are ready to fire. Number four, only point your firearm at something you are willing to destroy.
The Liberty Beat is sponsored by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. That's CoinArch.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. A new study published in the BMJ's Journal of Epidemiology and Community Health has confirmed fluoride's effect on the thyroid gland and a possible connection to depression. The research comes from the University of Kent in England, which examined thyroid activity for those in areas with fluoridated water and those without. The researchers found high rates of underactive thyroid were 30% more likely in areas with high fluoride concentration. An underactive thyroid can lead to depression, weight gain, fatigue, and aching muscles. An officer with the Houston, Texas Police Department was recently filmed telling an open carry activist he was uninterested in his, quote, constitutional expletive. The officer confronted the activist with Open Carry Texas, demanding identification before placing the man in handcuffs while he worked to establish identity. At one point, the officer threatened to escalate the situation while holding his automatic rifle. Eventually, the officer let the activist go, but not before making it clear he has little respect or concern for constitutional law. Open Carry Texas regularly passes out flyers in public, working to inform the public about constitutional carry in Texas. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers such as Charlie Schrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Shortly after creating a profile on OkCupid.com, local man Malcolm Lighty, a person with severe psychological and emotional issues, told reporters he thought it was best to just never mention the fact there was something seriously wrong with him on the popular dating website.
The thing about online dating is you don't want to get too personal too quickly. Like, for example, how I'm a textbook narcissist with unresolved intimacy issues, or the fact that I have no sense of empathy. Nobody wants to hear about that. When you're making a first impression, it's important that you keep it casual and don't include too much information. You don't want to be talking about your inability to maintain a relationship because of a history of violent mood swings.
Lighty told reporters while his OkCupid profile includes extensive details about his favorite movies, love of cooking, and interest in cars, he thought he was, quote, just better off not mentioning the borderline personality disorder that makes it impossible for him to connect with another person on any kind of meaningful level.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
Christopher Cantwell visiting from ChristopherCantwell.com.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah, thanks so much for coming on. Let's go straight to the phones. That's what we do here on Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. Or you can call in on Skype. That's what Derek J. did here. Our username is lrn.fm. Derek J., what's on your mind?
Where are you calling from, Derek?
Some good news for everyone, and I'm calling from above the LRN studios. I wanted to let you know that something amazing happened yesterday. A boy about 5 years old was scheduled to have a circumcision, and it was canceled due to the efforts of peace activists who didn't want that to happen.
Is this in Florida?
Yes.
Okay, I'm familiar with the case. Yeah.
Okay, so you're familiar. Just to fill in the other listeners, in November of last year, in 2014, the Florida court ordered a circumcision of a perfectly healthy four-year-old boy. This is because his parents had an arrangement that they agreed to that he would be circumcised. However, after some research, his mother decided this was not in his best interest and decided to cancel it. The court ordered this to happen. It was scheduled to happen yesterday. There were protests outside of the doctor's office. And I think it was due to the public pressure of these peaceful activists simply standing there holding signs and making their voices known on social media that the doctor's office canceled this circumcision. No.
So it was the doctor's office that canceled? It wasn't the father?
Yes.
It was the father demanding it, though?
The father is demanding it. He's still demanding it. And so it's uncertain what's going to happen here on out. But I just think it's an amazing story that peace activists can affect real change. I mean, this affects this young boy's life forever.
Hopefully it affects it forever. If their court has ordered it and the facility decided not to do it because of the public backlash,
it's sure getting to be too late. So here's my thoughts on circumcision. There's no doubt that some people need an operation in order for the foreskin to sort of function properly. No doubt about it. But circumcision has been prescribed for as a medical procedure. More things circumcision is supposed to fix more things than any other procedure ever in the history of man. It's amazing when you sort of look historically about all the things this is supposed to prevent. Now it's sort of dirty parts and premature ejaculation. Nonsense, of course, but I think that. Essentially, you should have people's permission to cut parts of their body unless it's necessary sort of as, for their life and comfort and things like that. If we're going to claim that a kid doesn't have license to make all kinds of decisions like signing contracts, having sex, smoking cigarettes and doing those kind of things, then a parent shouldn't be able to make the decision that they just automatically get a circumcision because they think it's a good idea. Now, if the kid needs it as a medical operation, I'm fine with that. But I feel the same way about tattoos and ear piercings. I think little baby girls with pierced ears are just cute as they could possibly be. But I don't think that's a decision that a parent should be making for somebody. I think that that's a decision that somebody needs to make for themselves and that you should deliver them at the least to like their 14th birthday with whole ears and then they can decide or something like that.
This is not a medical emergency.
No.
Boy's name is Chase. He's perfectly aware of his body. He's now 5 years old. He's going to notice a difference. Now, whether or not they use anesthetic, in many cases they don't during circumcisions of younger children.
Right, much younger children, yeah.
Right. In this case, they'll probably use an anesthetic.
Sure.
However, he is self-aware and knows about his body. He will notice a change.
I suspect he doesn't want a circumcision either. I haven't met too many five-year-olds that are looking forward to getting parts of their bodies cut. Now, I'm not going to claim I'm not going to claim at 5 years old he should be the only one making that decision. And I think it's very problematic that the mother, agreed to this early on. I think that the decision lies with the parents with this, but I would encourage them strongly not to make that decision. So I do think it's an interesting story.
Yeah, this kid's going to remember that. Like, I had this done to me when I was extraordinarily young, but to try to do that to me today, and I'd have to remember it? Oh, my God.
Well, actually, I've met a guy who claims to have remembered his, but I think that humans are amazing creatures. Derek J., thanks for the call.
Thank you.
855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Let's go to Michael calling in from Rhode Island. Hi. Michael, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, what's up, boys? Cantwell, Mark, hope you're doing well. But I'm not going to ask how you're doing. So I just wanted to touch on the... yeah, I just wanted to touch on some of these chemtrail boys earlier tonight.
Touch away.
I used to be... Cool. Yeah, I used to be on the conspiracy train, and I'm not going to say I ever bought into chemtrails, but I did used to think like, hey, what are these lines in the sky? And I would always revert to, I don't remember seeing lines in the sky when I was a little kid, right? In hindsight, when I was a kid, I was kind of worried about getting weed and having people buy me beer underage rather than looking up at the sky. So my that wasn't entirely in my priorities. But I did start to notice it a few years ago. And yeah, this is through Alex Jones and all these conspiracy circles. But just like Mark mentioned earlier, it was brought to my attention that, like, if this is really the case, if these people are trying to poison, I don't know, the depopulate with aluminum and brainium or whatever it is, then aren't they poisoning themselves too? And that thought crossed my head, and I'm like, well, I just don't buy it anymore, you know?
Well, I suppose that if I was to take the other side, I suppose that if I was, you know, the evil mastermind behind this and I wanted to depopulate the planet, I could tell the pilots that, in fact, this is to stop global warming. And it's very, but it's, you know, it's in the gray area as far as legality goes. It's for people's best interests. So therefore, we have to have your compliance and make sure that you never tell. But I just don't believe at some point one of these pilots wouldn't read something on the internet about chemtrails and say, oh my goodness, you must be right. I should at least leak a picture of one of these planes that sprays this stuff. And so far, we have no pictures of planes that spray this stuff.
No, we probably do because it's on Before It's News and it's on Above Top Secret and it's...
There's a very interesting picture of the inside of a 747 that has these machines that look like washing machines in them. And they are just interesting as they could possibly be. Turns out that when you test... seven airplanes before they did computer models, but you'd need to have, you know, weight in them to simulate passengers. Like, you would want, instead of testing a plane full of people that you have to pay to get up there, you would say, take all the water and push it over to one side of the plane and see how the plane reacts and that sort of thing. So they do have a very interesting picture, but it turns out it has a reasonable explanation.
Right. Just like gods or government, when it comes to anything, I require empirical evidence in order to believe it, right? I'm not taking the position that I am sympathetic to government, right? Like, I don't trust them no matter what, and I put nothing past them. I just kind of require evidence sometimes.
Well, yeah,
and like the caller...
You're also giving
like
them a lot of credit.
Was saying earlier...
They'd have to have a lot of credit like to be able to keep... Was, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's like three times now. Like the caller was saying earlier about, well, if we can't find these pictures, the lack of these pictures is not does not disprove chemtrails.
It's true.
Well, I think that it does. I mean, if this has been going on for such a long period of time and all of these pilots, co-pilots, who are the people who bring drinks to you on a plane?
Stewardesses. Stewards.
Right. Stewardesses. All of these people involved are not leaking a single photo. And if they are aware, and I guess that's a whole other argument, but if they are aware that this is happening, they're poisoning their own children, families, and parents too, and friends too, then I would suspect that at least a picture would be leaked. And I'm not going to believe it until I have that.
It's evidence, but it doesn't prove it, because you can't disprove something that doesn't at this point there's no proof exists, right? Like, I can't prove that there isn't an invisible, weightless bunny rabbit jumping on up and down on top of my head, because I can't prove that it's there. Like, it's just not possible.
Right.
I can't prove or disprove it.
But with the frequency with which these folks are reporting seeing these things, especially when they live by Air Force bases and airports, and they're saying, they're crisscrossing the sky, it's happening all the time. I'm like, look, you know, there's a certain logical deduction that's going on here.
Well, sometimes you're just in the path of where airplanes go.
Yeah.
You know?
Right. That's
the way it is. I'm just going to take Ian's position on this, and I really don't do that often. I disagree with Ian more than I do. But I'm going to take his position and, like, I'm just going to focus on things that I don't need to prove. I'm going to focus on things that are evident.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Okay, guys, when it comes to shaving, you've got to check out Harrys.com. Why pay $32 for an 8-pack of blades? Harry's high-quality German-engineered blades are half the price of drugstore brands. Harry's starter set with a razor, 3 blades, and shave cream is just $15 with free shipping. With promo code 5858, you get $5 off your first order. After using code 5858 at checkout, you can get an entire month's worth of shaving for just $10. That's Harrys.com, code 5858.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live.
We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That's our fast way of saying it, 855-450-FREE. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. We also have Skype. Our username there is lrn.fm. Call us there. Maybe you'll sound a bit better. Or you can call us at 855-450-FREE. We're going to the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. It's in downtown Austin on March the 28th and 29th. So you got a little time still to plan for it, about a month. But I encourage you to go and hang out with us because they're going to have great speakers. George Gilder, this is the guy who basically created Reaganomics. Also, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Adept. And I have been misassigning Symbolinaire's gender for on the air. I didn't really sort of research. I don't know why I decided that Symbola must be a male name, but apparently that's what I did. Symbolinaire will be flying in from India, and she is a pretty big deal. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, I can't wait to see Bob Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, Charlie Shrim, who I also would like to see. It's going to be a great great time, and I think the biggest deal, the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon, where you will get to glimpse the future and even going beyond Bitcoin, and it'll all be in Austin, in Texas, March the 28th and 29th. Go to texasbitcoinconference.com, get your tickets. If you use coupon code FTL, you get a $25 discount. That's off the $150 admission price. It's, of course, affordable, these kinds of events. That's a really cheap price. So $125, significantly more affordable. And $25 of that goes to feed homeless people through Sean's Outpost. It is TexasBitcoinConference.com. Please use coupon code FTL. Let's go talk to Glenn in Philly. Glenn, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Good evening, gentlemen. I was listening to you discuss the land ownership rights thing, and you glossed over a really important point.
Well, let me quickly say. So a gentleman called in the last hour. Basically, what his statement was is that there are different ideas in the libertarian sphere, new thoughts suggesting that in some cases that people can't own land at all, that land is just sort of this sort of property that cannot be owned. And whereas other people believe that, of course, land can be owned, and sort of the different theories that evolve there. So go ahead, Glenn.
Right, and this is, of course, a perennial topic, and I think it's interesting it manifests itself through the entertainment, you know, subculture from time to time.
Right, well, I don't remember what the band's name is, but they do the signs everywhere, there's signs, you know.
Where the guy jumps on the fence and he yells, hey, what gives you the right to put up a fence? Well, before that, there was share the land. Baby, I'll be there to take your hand. Baby, I'll be there to share the land that they'll be giving away when we all live together. That was like the 60s.
Oh, there you go.
Share the Land, a very famous song. Let's see, what else? Oh, and of course, we've had Madonna telling us she's given up the illusion that we can possess while she's possessing millions, gazillions of dollars, but...
Possess? She possesses all kinds of things.
The illusion that we can possess, but, you know, it's in like
it's
a line.
It's a talk show, not a karaoke bar.
An actor, comedian Eddie Izzard made it, you know, very clear in one of his comedic routines called "Dress to Kill," where he, you know, addressed the notion that the key to the whole land ownership thing is having a flag. So you need to have like a flag with some really fancy designs and stuff, and you stick it in the ground, and then it's yours, you know. It doesn't matter if there's somebody, there are guys with, we were living here, just because you pull up in your ship and you stuck a flag in the ground, doesn't make it yours. But he does a great routine on that.
Is that land ownership really comes down to having a colorful piece of fabric?
Yes, you have to have a stick and a flag. You stick it in the ground, and then it's yours.
Well, I've got to correct you there. It comes back to what I said. It's how long you can defend it, because you know what? There's a lot of guys with flags, and then guys with flags and tanks come in and take your flags and take your land take your everything.
Well, I guess I need to design a flag. I'll get started tonight.
Yeah, you need a flag, and a tank or two does help. Yeah, absolutely. Very important concept.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn this – my son and I, we do we unschool. So we do little projects together. We're doing lesson plans as far as I'm concerned. He just thinks we're playing around. I think this is something that I'm going to do with my son Jack, is we're going to design a flag. We're going to look at the flags of the world. I particularly like Cornwall's. We're going to look at the flags of the world, and we're going to come up with something for our property that we like, and we'll see what we think about it. You got to have stars. Stars, that's the big thing with flags. Thanks for the call, Glenn.
Just put a maple leaf on there.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Let's go to Hunter, calling in from California. Listening online. Hunter, you're on Free Talk Live.
How's it going, guys?
All's well.
Awesome. So I wanted to talk to you guys. I saw Chris's video about rape culture is bullshit. I really liked it.
Oh, sorry, buddy. I'd love to have talked about it, but I know you're listening on the internet, but... The FCC doesn't approve of that sort of thing.
No. They're bored up. Man, that guy's like lightning fast. He's like a cobra.
He got it?
Oh, yeah, he got it. He got it with a single tap.
Well done, sir.
When I do it, I do the double tap and like drop 7 seconds out of the show. He's like, I got this. 3.5. Ba-boom. You know, and it's gone. Zip.
Nice.
Now, so for people that get dropped, you know, this is how it goes, right? Like, that's the rule. You say the you say one of the six words or so that you can't say on the air, we're going to drop you. But you can call in with your topic tomorrow. Is all you have to do is just call back, 855-450-FREE. And
but
by the way,
I won't be here tomorrow, and he wanted to talk to me, so he's going to have to wait until Wednesday. Or you can call into Some Garbage Podcast on Fridays from 5 to 7 p.m.
There you go. No problem at all. Just that's the way we do it around here. Yeah, you know, it's the little electric shock for stepping out of line. 855-450-3733. You know, we have been rolling on phone calls the whole evening. It's amazing.
Yeah,
I'm surprised. Well, I did tease this in the very early part of the show. It's from the Free Thought Project. In a letter to D.C. Mayor Muriel E. Bowser, two Republican congressmen, that's Representative Jason Chaffetz, Republican from Utah, and Chairman of the House Ways House Oversight and Government Reform Committee, and Representative Mark Meadows, North Carolina Republican, Chair of the Appropriations Subcommittee that handles the D.C.'s budget, ominously warned not to move forward with the legalization in the District of Columbia, claiming that to do so would be a violation of federal law. And they're not stopping there. D.C. officials and federal lawmakers have sparred over whether Initiative 71, a ballot to measure to prove approved by 70% of voters in November, that basically legalizes 2 ounces of marijuana or higher. It's supposed to become law at 12 a.m. on 12 a.m. or on Thursday. If you decide to move forward tomorrow with the legalization of marijuana in the district, you will be doing so knowing and willful violation of the law, said the letter. They're threatening jail. 855-450-3733. You don't find the government bureaucrats head-to-head like this too often.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Like most married couples, Dale and Barbara Patterson like to shake things up from time to time. The couple of 12 years says they've been able to keep their relationship spontaneous and interesting by bickering in all sorts of different positions and even different rooms.
There was a while there when our petty nitpicking got pretty predictable. Dale would finish harping on some stupid bullshit first, and before I had time to get a word in, he would just let out a groan, roll over, and fall asleep. Now he really takes his time ripping me a new one over every little thing.
Yeah, we'll just pounce on each other the second we get home from work in the evening. And then just go right back at it in the morning. I mean, sometimes we'll look at each other directly in the eyes when we're having an argument. Other times she turns her back on me and I just scream at her from behind.
We're not exactly shy about doing it in public anymore. Dale gets pretty worked up when there are people around who could be watching or listening.
I still can't believe you forgot.
Not now.
Oh, come on.
I said not now.
Oh, what? Don't even.
Don't even what? I asked.
This is the Onion News Network.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want here on this live edition of Free Talk Live. It's Mark.
And Cantwell.
855-450-3733. BuzzBox Coffee. You can get a free pound of some of the best coffee you've ever tasted. Really awesome coffee. Take my word for it. I wouldn't steer you wrong. This is some of the best coffee you've ever had. And you can get it by simply going to coffee.freetalklive.com. You get a free pound. It's 100% organic, shade grown. And this is the top 1% of Arabica beans, which, of course, the best beans. Now, it is a subscription
and
program.
All the other coffees are like, we are the 99%.
They are. Don't step down to the 99% when it comes to coffees. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com, sign up for the subscription program. You can cancel it anytime. You have to pay for the shipping on the pound, but we're going to give it to you. We know you want to try this, so we're going to make it easy. Now, if you continue on the subscription program, you will help us help others. As a matter of fact, I will be giving out a couple more loans to people through Kiva.org. These are people around the world who, for whatever reason, are asking for money to sort of be able to do businesses. It usually has to do with businesses. That's what they're looking to do. And I try to support them in those endeavors because I believe people need a hand up, not a handout. I don't believe in those. It's coffee.freetalklive.com to get your free pound. Let's go to Dave, I believe, calling in from Montana. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, yo, viva cannabis, long live Free Talk Live, man.
What's going on, Dave?
Greetings from high on top of the Purple Mountain Majesties, man, in the lovely winter we have in
here. Yeah.
All the bad weather went over by you guys. You ripped us off for all our cold weather and snow, man.
I'd be happy to give it back.
Hey, I called about the DHS. They're getting what, like defunded or something like that?
What? You have to tell me
there's
more.
There's a standoff going on in the Congress that if they don't come to some sort of agreement that the Department of Homeland Security will not be funded. Now, I don't for one second think that that's going to happen, so I just looked at it as political theater, and I have not looked into the story.
Well, the only thing I could see coming out of that is something bigger and badder and more of a monster than the DHS. That's all, because you got like 250,000 people employed by them already. That thing is like big wheels turning already. Well, and it ain't going to stop.
You know? I understand something. I believe that 250,000 number, I don't know if that's for the DHS central thing, right?
No.
If DHS encompasses a number of different agencies, and those agencies, I believe, will still be funded.
They existed already. Many of those agencies were just sort of put under the umbrella of the Department of Homeland Security.
Yeah. DHS is supposed to be some central planning thing to get, you know, the CIA and the NSA on the same page or
that
something
works.
Like that. And it doesn't seem to be panning
coming out so well. But in any case, yeah, that's the big threat that, you know, well, we're not going to have this particular central planning agency. And then because this agency that wasn't here before 9/11 is going to be unfunded, then there's going to be a 9/11. So F you pay me.
Right, right. That's what I was going to say. 250,000 people unemployed. They're like a big power block, man. They'd make something happen to show that they're needed, you know?
Again, it's not 250,000 people who would be, like, laid off if the Department of Homeland Security went down. The NSA is still going to run. The CIA is still going to run. These agencies are still going to be there.
It's not even going to be 1% of that.
There's a handful of people who work for Department of Homeland Security proper, and I don't know what that number is, but it's not in the six figures. It's a much smaller number. But, of course, yeah, there's a bunch of bureaucrats who are going to get laid off, and they're going to go raise heck with the media and say, without me, you'd all be dead, so give me money.
Or make one big giant one that's, you know, like compared to the SS or something like that, you know?
Well, I mean, that's what the DHS was Interpol. Supposed to be.
They'll join, you know, with Interpol. You hear about the UN is freaking out about all the states legalizing cannabis for
really?
Medical
The purpose. UN is?
Yeah, they're freaking out
I'm
heavy.
I'm surprised at that. I wouldn't have thought they would have made a big deal about it.
They're demanding that Obama do something about it. They don't like it at all, man. They're freaking
out. Why do you think
out.
That is, Dave?
They like the monopoly of it. They know if people could grow the most useful plant on the planet, that people would be able to feed themselves, clothe themselves, house themselves, make fuel, have medicine, and stay off of these psychotropic drugs that make you go around shooting people and stuff, because every shooter was on them happy pills. That's a known fact.
Doesn't seem very happy, do they?
But anyway, they're up in arms all about it. You know, it's a big scam. Look what's right now, medical marijuana in legal states, it's more expensive than street weed. You could get just as good street weed for what you got to pay for in them clinics, man.
It's true. It seems like very odd.
Something is wrong.
Marijuana hasn't this thing that you can grow pretty much anywhere hasn't come down in price.
Something is very, very wrong, man, about that. It shows that the greedy son of a guns are still in charge, and they just walked over the line and took over, man.
Right. If you look at what a tomato costs in the store, I don't know what the price of tomatoes
right,
is.
Right, and tomatoes are harder to grow than
they're harder
cannabis.
To grow than weed. I mean, that is the God's honest truth. You can get the best weed seeds, toss them in the ground, you know, some water
how
ought
come,
to help.
How come tomatoes ain't $400, right?
It just doesn't make any sense to me. I'm going to assume the market will correct over time, but I don't get it. Why in Washington and Colorado do these, you know, are things the way they are? I guess that's why they have the edibles, like the sodas and the cookies and things like that.
And it puts out the reach. Like, you figure it takes 1 pound of good buds to make 2.5 ounces of oil of cannabis.
Okay.
The very medicine that you need. And 2.5 ounces is maybe a 3 month you know, prescription kind of.
Okay.
So a 1 pound of good buds is like, you know, $3,000. You know, that's still out of the reach of the common man. That a pound of a weed for $3,000, that's absurd. You know, that it should be that they could be able, you can't even grow a pound to make your medicine because you'd be over your 2 ounce limit or whatever they put on it, some stupid limit, you know, that yep. You can't even grow enough to make your medicine.
Yeah, I mean, you should be able to grow these plants as big as you want in your backyard, and you know, get whatever it is you want to do with them, whether it's for medicine or for food or for whatever you want to do.
I see.
Well, once they're going to tax it, then they're going to obviously want to manipulate the market in order to keep the price up high, right? I mean, what is it? Washington, you're putting a 25% tax on a product 3 times. And you're going to do everything in your power to regulate that market as much as humanly possible to make sure that that 25% on 3 different transactions is going to net you the most amount of cash.
Yep. Dave, thanks for the call. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It seems to me that we're living in a time where It just like marijuana. This is it. This is the time for marijuana to be legalized. You know, it was silly to have made it illegal less than 100 years ago, I believe, is the time frame. But about that, you know, longer than most people are alive, at least that would remember it. But it seems like, you know, the momentum's there. More than 50 states in the union have it as medical. Two states have legalized
more than 50 states in the
more
union?
More than 50% of the states in the union. Thank you for so much for if I brushed past that statistic. But, you know, now two of them have just made it legal. Texas is, Colorado. What? Colorado.
Colorado Washington. And Washington already did it. I think Alaska did it yesterday.
Yep. Washington, D.C. is supposed to do it tonight if assuming they don't get thrown in jail here, according to this article from the Free Thought Project. An interview with the Washington Post, Representative Chevitz went further, saying that if Bowser, that's the mayor of Washington, D.C., and the city officials are under any illusion that this would be legal, they are wrong. And there are very severe consequences for violating this provision. You can go to prison for this. We're not playing a little game here. The Washington politicians are not fooling around, though. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If
you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855 450 free. Mark with you.
Cantwell.
ChristopherCantwell.com. You can give us a call and talk about whatever's on your mind at 855 450 3733 or on Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. We also give away our archives going back for many years at archives.freetalklive.com for free. Other talk show hosts, they charge you for it. We don't do it. archives.freetalklive.com. You know, that's we just want you to get the audio that you want to get, and we make it easy for you. Going on with this article from the freethoughtproject.com about, well, U.S. representatives who are threatening the mayor and city officials of Washington, D.C. that are supposed to legalize marijuana tonight at 12:01 a.m., tomorrow morning, marijuana is supposed to be legal in Washington, D.C.
Sounds like a blast.
Yeah. But you're not supposed to smoke it outside, which, of course, they will. And so, but the representatives.
This is not fair. Wasn't the mayor of D.C. smoking crack? I mean, it just seems reasonable to suggest that these people might smoke a little marijuana outside if they've waited all this time to legalize it.
I think that there should be a grace period for the party. You know, one day outside.
Seems reasonable.
Period. Yeah. Anyway, it goes on. The letter goes on to state that if the city moves forward with legalization, Congress could potentially charge D.C. city officials with violating the Anti-Deficiency Act. The Anti-Deficiency Act says that the district can't spend any funds not appropriated by them. In addition, the letter requests an accounting of all monies spent on enacting the legalization measure. It states that the city provide names of any city employees that assist in any action relating to the enactment of Initiative 71.
How much money did you spend on not enforcing your ridiculous drug laws?
Right, that's kind of really sort of interesting, is if you just basically say, we are, here's a memo. And that memo is that, you know, sent out by email. What's that cost? I've got a salary, but you really can't say, since I give all of my time, that I could have time off. You can't say that I did it on the clock or off the clock, right?
Yeah.
So I'm sending out an email to all law enforcement officers in the city of Washington, D.C. You need to deprioritize the arrest of marijuana to the lowest possible priority level.
Which is zero.
Zero. And there you go. There's what costs are we talking about here?
Yeah, it's... I can't wait to see how this pans out.
The overreach of the federal government is stunning and provides an unobstructed view of your average American to the average American of what federal tyranny looks like. The ballot initiative got 70% of the vote, but congressmen from Utah and North Carolina are attempting to usurp the will of the D.C. residents that carried the initiative to an overwhelming success. While addressing questions about the law Tuesday morning, Mayor Bowser... and said the district would enact the law, and she and Representative Meadows had spoken about the law. I don't know what the Congress will do, but I do know that my job is at this point, and that's to make sure that we have clear rules and guidelines for the people of the District of Columbia and agencies of our government, Mayor Bowser said Tuesday, according to the Washington Times. With the passage of Initiative 71, it will be legal for people 21 and older to possess up to 2 ounces of marijuana. That's not a small amount of weed, by the way. I mean, you know, if you're making oil.
More than you're probably going to smoke in the course of an evening.
Yeah. You're smoking like a broke microwave if you can smoke more than 2 ounces of weed. You've just made a campfire and you're sitting next to it. Let's see. For recreational use, transfer up to an ounce to others and grow up to 6 plants inside of a dwelling. Thus far, regulation of the sale has failed to manifest as Congress continues to fight to keep it illicit in the district. So Congress is basically stopping you from being able to sell it, but they can't stop you from growing it. They can't stop you from having it. Here's a surprise, folks. Their laws haven't stopped it for decades.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be panning out so well, this whole war on drugs things, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe you get off that train and try to do something reasonable. Yeah, it seems funny to me that they're going to say, well, we need a full accounting of all the money that you're not spending on this thing so we can bill you for it later on.
The reality is that the winds of change are blowing strong, and someone visiting D.C. and on the buck of the U.S. taxpayer should have no ability to override the free will exercised by the denizens of the District of Columbia. The war on drugs is an absolute failure, and legalization of marijuana is taking place all over the country on a state level. The federal legalization was introduced in the House recently to legalize marijuana on the federal level. If the federal government believes that it can stop the movement that is underway, they're sadly mistaken. Just as prohibition of alcohol was doomed to fail, so is the prohibition of marijuana. The will of 70% of the voters can easily be disregarded. Perhaps we should, if it can be so easily disregarded, perhaps we should question whether the voting means anything at all. Like, why should those people be in Washington, D.C.? Right?
Isn't that 70% of us want to do this thing while a bunch of people are claiming that they're running a democracy and they're like, hey, F you. Right? You can't do that.
These representatives, these Republican representatives, and I'm by no means a Democrat, but I think we should point out, we should lay blame where blame belongs. These two Republicans from Utah and North Carolina were likely elected with a smaller than by a smaller margin than 70%. I'm just going by looking at
chances are
it seems like it, just by my experience and looking at these things. So who do they think they are going in there and telling this group of people that elected it by a 70% margin that they can't do it?
Sorry to tell you, Mr. Representative, you're less popular than an illegal plant.
Yeah, I think that there was some poll that the United States Congress was less popular than roaches. People filled out a poll, and more of them were fond of roaches.
Yeah, vegans refuse to kill roaches.
you think we could get the vegans on board with killing the politicians? I don't know. I don't think that's the solution, but there's always going to be somebody who's willing to seize power from somebody else. And here they're doing it under the color of law, right? They're saying, like, you haven't followed the exact rules. Now, the Washington, D.C.'s city government says the federal government hasn't followed the exact rules either. So it gets very confusing on this as far as things go.
Yeah, I'll say they haven't followed the exact rules. I mean, you folks needed a constitutional amendment to ban alcohol, and then you needed a constitutional amendment to legalize it. So it wouldn't seem to me that you guys had any authority to just get together in Congress and go ban a whole bunch of stuff and then give authority to the DEA to ban stuff without a law even being passed. Just delegating authority left and right, and it's just
When you say that, what you mean is there's these synthetic drugs out there that the DEA will just sort of change the rules and designate certain chemical substances as illegal without it going through the legal channels, right?
Right, exactly. So basically, the DEA has some regulatory power to turn a possession of a substance into a felony with the stroke of a pen, these people. And they'll just say, hey, it's illegal today, and if you have it, I don't know if there's any time limit on it, but it could be as soon as 15 minutes from now, perhaps, that they say, hey, Cantwell, all those nootropics that you have, all those white powders that you have in those bags that you're putting into those capsules in your apartment there, they're illegal now, and you better go flush them down the toilet before we come raid your house.
What are these nootropics that you're taking? I mean, I've heard you talk about them a little bit.
I am presently on aniracetam, Nupept, Alcar, and it's not a nootropic, but a stimulant called Hordenine. So I basically have found
some... Oh, yeah, what you need is a stimulant.
Oh, yeah. they are smart drugs. The idea is being the, at least the nootropics are
smarter?
Things that help cognitive function. I feel more clear-headed. I feel more in control of my thoughts. I do believe it's helping with my verbal fluidity and whatnot.
Oh. Well, there you go.
But I've actually taken, there's a thing, Cambridge Brain Sciences, where they have these like brain, you know, teaser tests that you go and you know, how many numbers can you remember? And I don't see a significant improvement in my scores from when I'm not on them to when I am on them. It's like I'm on or I'm off.
If you feel like you have something better going on, I'd continue. If we're talking about a placebo that makes you feel better, I recommend the placebo that makes you feel better.
Certainly.
Over time, that might be a good thing. Anyway, apparently these two U.S. representatives believe that the legislative branch of the government has its own cops because they're telling the executive branch of the D.C. Body that they can't follow the will of the people. So,
come and get me.
Weird stuff. 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm on Skype. 855-450-FREE.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Gabino lives in Paucapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.63 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,209 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports Israel's Channel 2 is claiming Saudi Arabia is close to agreeing to let Israel use their airspace to attack Iran, something Israel has been reported to be seeking for many years. The latest report says that Saudi Arabia would be willing to let them use their airspace, but only if Israel makes some progress on a peace deal with the Palestinians. The theory is that Saudi Arabia would be able to get away with cooperating on the attack with less regional backlash if Israel was making some credible progress on the peace deal. Still, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says he is determined to prevent any deal between Iran and the P5+1, and attacking Iran would certainly be one way of killing the diplomatic process. Netanyahu's aversion to making any progress on the peace with Palestinians, however, makes that concession unlikely. It should be noted that Israeli papers have been reporting similar deals in the past, only for Saudi Arabia to come out and deny them in a day or two. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports President Barack Obama on Tuesday made good on his promise to veto legislation in support of the Keystone XL pipeline should it cross his desk. He vetoed the bill that called for the 1,179-mile pipeline construction to transport crude oil from Canada to the Texas Gulf Coast. The House of Representatives passed the bill with a vote of 270 to 152 earlier this month, and the Senate passed it with a vote of 62 to 36 in January. Neither vote was strong enough to overcome a presidential veto. Obama said in his veto message, the bill attempts to circumvent longstanding and proven processes for determining whether or not building and operating cross-border pipelines serves the national interest, adding, because this act of Congress conflicts with established executive branch procedures and cuts short through consideration of issues that could bear on our national interest, including our security, safety, and environment, it has earned my veto. The project, had the bill been signed by Obama, would have cost $8 billion. Supporters said it would have created jobs in the United States and reduced the country's dependency on foreign oil. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a Los Angeles-bound commuter train slammed into a tractor-trailer truck, apparently stuck on the tracks in a Southern California city before dawn on Tuesday, injuring 50 people in a fiery crash, four of them critically. The truck driver, who was not hurt, left the scene of the destruction on foot and was found walking and talking on a cell phone in some sort of distress more than a mile and a half away. Assistant Police Chief Jason Benitez said Jose Alejandro Sanchez Ramirez was taken into custody on felony hit-and-run charges for leaving the scene of the accident. While no one was killed, the force of the impact overturned three double-decker Metrolink rail cars and derailed two others, ripped the truck apart, and left burning chunks of twisted wreckage still smoldering hours later. Benitez said it appeared that the truck driver, who was towing a trailer full of welding equipment, had taken a wrong turn in the pre-dawn darkness and ended up on the tracks, where the rig became stuck and the train approached at 79 miles per hour. Benitez declined to say what led police to arrest Sanchez Ramirez, other than that he had left the scene of the accident. He said the driver had undergone unspecified tests at a hospital and that investigators were looking into the possibility of drugs or alcohol being involved in the crash. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
And if you thought things couldn't get more infantile and aesthetically insulting than Fergie, Kesha, or Katy Perry, then you obviously haven't met 22-year-old Karanika, the latest and most horrid, talent-bereft pop monstrosity the music industry has ever sadistically forced down the American public's collective throat. She's here with us in the studio right now.
What?
Now tell us, Karanika, how did you first decide that you wanted to be the cipher through which the cynicism of a morally bankrupt industry is channeled?
Yo, I just do what I do. Know what I'm saying? It's like, people just love my ish.
Right. You are in the middle of your sold-out Damn Girl tour.
Damn Girl! That's right!
Which is a heinous slap in the face to the English language and will also travel to 47 what? Cities, sapping the intellects of every young person along the way.
I said Damn Girl! That's right!
There's no light in your eyes, Karanika.
I got nothing to say to the haters.
I hate you.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. That's our toll-free line. You can call us and talk about, well, whatever's on your mind. It's 855-450-FREE. Or you can use Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. You send us a contact request. I'll click it as soon as I see it, which, you know, usually within a few minutes. And then you can call us and sound a little better. It's 855-450-FREE for the landline and lrn.fm on Skype. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
Cantwell, what's going on? What happened at the Students for Liberty International Conference thing down
the
in
International
DC?
Students for Liberty Conference, ISFLC,
yeah,
has me in an absolute uproar to the point that I really don't even know what to do with myself. I'm really very frustrated with the situation. There was a I have been going after certain factions of the libertarian movements for quite some period of time here. These social justice warriors absolutely make me sick. The
now, social justice can be two different. Like
don't even. There's nothing. There's no good definition of social justice. And if you want to try to do it, just to do it for the radio, go ahead. But I'm gonna get it out there that this is complete nonsense, and you know it.
I tend to think that most people that are for social justice, as they call it, are for government enacted social justice. But sometimes they'll run under the cover of non-government enacted social justice. So,
they will run under that cover, but that's basically, look, these people are anti-capitalists, is what it is. Okay, they hate capitalism. They hate rich people. They hate goodness.
Well,
right?
I wish that I knew what capitalism was, because that's a really vague term for a lot of people.
Then that's
right?
What we're going to do. Forget Students for Liberty. Let's do this.
Okay.
Because I am sick of this one, too. And this is something that needs to get fixed in the libertarian movement. I am sick of this. I mentioned to a previous caller, I sat down with this ridiculous Markets Not Capitalism audiobook that I'm trying to get through. And it's word salad. It's communist word salad. It's completely ridiculous that people are basically talking about free market anti-capitalism, and that what it is they don't like the accumulation of wealth. What they see it as is that when people have somebody has more than somebody else, that they will use it to oppress people, is kind of the idea.
I'm with you on that. I think that when people hate on the rich, that many times they're not hating on people who have used the government apparatus in order to enrich themselves, immorally. They're hating on people who have provided goods and services in the marketplace and been rewarded through that behavior.
Yeah. You paying me the least amount of money that you have to is wage slavery, as far as these people are concerned. Not you and me literally, but right, Somebody paying somebody something to do something that they don't particularly care to do, but that doesn't allow them to, a living wage or whatever, that this is wage slavery, that you're oppressing people, and it's infuriating to watch happen. Now, don't get me wrong, I understand that the government's messing with the economy. I absolutely get that.
Oh, yeah.
I know that there's a small number of people who are benefiting from that a lot more than everybody else. But the egalitarianism has got to go, ladies and gentlemen. This is the problem that leads up to this situation at the Students for Liberty conference, where somebody basically called out Ron Paul as a racist and the Mises Institute and Lou Rockwell and Walter Block, and just basically went on this social justice warrior rant trying to tear down the best people in the libertarian movement, in my book.
Let's go to Daniel calling in from San Francisco. Daniel, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, I just wanted to talk about this social justice thing.
Go ahead.
My girlfriend is a social worker, and she's not a Rothbardian anarchist, but she definitely has libertarian leanings, and she is very pro-capitalism and pro-markets and everything. Most of her work is with orphans who have been in the state system a lot and basically been spent most of their life super drugged up and have been sexually abused or survivors of child prostitution, that sort of thing.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure that they're going to have a difficult
really
time having a good life.
Messed up backgrounds, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Right.
And when I hear the phrase social justice, I know it's a word that people throw around a lot, and it basically means whatever it is I happen to be emotionally attached to.
Yeah, that means
she talks about that stuff in terms of social justice, because these are people who no one is vested in them. Like, there isn't really I can imagine hypothetical Rothbardian market solutions to these problems, but in the world we're in right now, these people are just being thrown under the bus and chewed up by the machine.
I agree with you on that. I think that what's difficult about the system, for instance, we've thought, my wife and I have thought about taking somebody, foster child in. I have never sort of moved forward on it because I'm certain that they're going to tell me I'm unqualified because I'm a convicted felon. And I just don't need that.
I'm a convicted felon too, so that's all right.
I don't need that crap in my life. I don't need some social worker telling me that I can't provide a better home for a foster kid. And foster kids are a challenge in and of themselves. But just because of, you know, something that happened 25 years ago that
has
never been meted out in a court of law.
Well, one of the things that she talks about a lot is that a lot of the people who, in her generation, I mean, she's like 26, and the people in her generation who are in the field, a lot of them are people who came out of the system themselves, who were orphans and got their shit together. And
whoa,
went to college
not again with this.
Oh, sorry, guys. Sorry.
Yep. That was the double tap. I double tapped it there. Our board op, who's fast as a cobra, had tapped it just before I tapped it. So there you go.
Well, you know, look, the situation that the guy was describing is there are some disadvantaged children, and his wife is a social worker who's got some governmental probably role to play in trying to get these kids on some sort of a right track. When we're talking about any of these things, there are market solutions to them, and it's a thing that you might want to do some study of economics if you want to start making these arguments. There's no shortage of demand for children.
Yeah.
But you can't sell them, unfortunately, right? And well, that sounds terribly cold for me to say, right?
I think it's really complicated because when you start incentivizing people to having children, right, like that's what buying children does, is it incentivizes people to have them, then we really get into a kind of a twisted situation.
Well,
right?
we might, but at the same time, I would say that when there's a market enough, the market to buy children would probably start off with a very high price, and then a bunch of people would get into it and be like, oh, I'm making so much money. And other people say, oh, I see these people making money. And all of a sudden, there's a surplus to, supply of children, and the price of children isn't so high. And all of a sudden, there's not quite so much incentive to go out and do that.
I think to some extent, you can already get scholarships, and there's money that can be a put away and trusts and that sort of thing.
But it's very difficult. It's not like the adoption process in this country is very simple. They go out overseas. Go ahead.
It is difficult. Let's go to Al calling in from Maine. Al, you're on Free Talk Live.
The market has turned America, the free market has turned America into a land of darkness, deep spiritual darkness.
So you think that some communism will turn us towards spiritual enlightenment? Is that your premise?
Communism and capitalism work hand in hand. They're the flip side of the same coin. They're controlled by the same people at the top.
Okay.
They're both a materialist ideology.
So we've just got to, like, not want stuff?
But no, hold on. Capitalism isn't controlled by its definition. Capitalism means the private ownership of the means of production, distribution, and exchange of wealth. So therefore, when you're talking about private, we're talking about everybody. There's 7 billion people involved in the capitalist free market. That's not top down.
Well, I find that an insufficient definition of capitalism.
Okay.
Capitalism is a concentration of the means of production. By accumulated wealth.
Yes, accumulated wealth is capital. You're using your capital to do things. Capitalism, I mean, I'll take that definition. Go ahead.
And it's used by lending, it grows by lending money, which is forbidden by all the major religions in the world.
Which is why religion is garbage and needs to be done away with as fast as possible.
Yes, and that's why, I mean, communists and capitalists share the same idea about religion. That religion is
the usury laws kept Europe in the Dark Ages for centuries.
Well, the usury kept Egypt. The West was never in the Dark Ages. That's a misnomer. You have the light of Christian civilization.
Thanks for the call, Al. Appreciate it. 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or, at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-3733. Free or LRN.FM on Skype. It's Mark.
And Cantwell.
ChristopherCantwell.com. You can get free tickets. Well, potentially. You can get free tickets to the New Hampshire Liberty Forum at NHLibertyForum.com. The Liberty Forum is really soon. It's the March the 5th through the 8th. It's going to be a great time. I'm excited to be there. It's going to be at the Radisson in downtown Manchester. From March the 5th to the 8th. And it's going to be a great time. Lots of great speakers. It's going to be amazing. Just go check it out, nhlibertyforum.com. But you can get a free ticket if you ask yourself, am I a Free State Project signer? If the answer is no, then ask yourself this. Do I live in New Hampshire? If the answer is no, then you're eligible. If you've answered no two times, then you're eligible for a free ticket to the New Hampshire Liberty Forum, as long as you're willing to attend the FSP questions session with Carla Mora on Saturday, the 7th at 12:30 in the afternoon. You do that, you're in there, you get to get a free ticket. All you have to do is email Ian at ian@freetalklive.com, and he will arrange it for you. So get your free ticket by emailing him at ian@freetalklive.com. And if you're like me and you don't fit either one of those and you just want to get a ticket and go and have a great time, like I'm going to, see us perform Free Talk Live and see all the great speakers, go to nhlibertyforum.com and get your tickets. Cantwell, apparently some left libertarians called Ron Paul a racist.
They certainly did, and a sexist and a homophobe and all sorts of things. And that's not unusual for these people, you know. And the thing is, you know, there's things that you could criticize Ron Paul on. I just don't think that this is one of them. In any case, so it's the International Students for Liberty Conference, and the Students for Liberty is a group that has sort of wanted to be a real big tent organization. Alexander McCobin is the president or the chair or whatever the leader of that organization
is. I've talked to him on the phone a few times. Yep.
You have. Okay, well, they were going after Ron Paul over Ukraine, accusing him of being pro-Putin. And
who's
there was,
they?
McCobin was.
Okay.
Okay, McCobin and some other people at Students for Liberty. And then there was a back and forth between these some folks over at the Ron Paul Institute were publishing pieces about McCobin. And I don't particularly care for McCobin because I perceive him to be a largely left-leaning guy with sympathy for the state. And in any case, there was all this lead up to it. Everybody knew that there was going to be a showdown at the ISFLC, anybody who was paying attention anyway. And so when Ron Paul goes there to speak against every intelligent thing that anybody planning anything should have just told him not to have anything to do with them, as far as I'm concerned, he goes there to speak. And of course, some folks from the Center for a Stateless Society, who are also in Students for Liberty, decide to disrupt Ron Paul's address to these folks to read out this open letter to Ron Paul that accuses him and Lou Rockwell and the Mises Institute and Walter Block and a handful of other people of being racist and misogynists and homophobes, and that they're ruining the libertarian movement because we can't reach out of this tiny little demographic, and it's all because of these racist old people, and we need second wave libertarianism to come in and rescue the libertarian movement.
Well,
and by the way, these are a bunch of anti-capitalist social justice warriors who are doing it.
Well, I do. Okay, I'll say this, that when I was doing some radio appearances during the Ron Paul campaigns during 2008 and 2012, some of the first things that I'd hear out of people's mouths, especially Democrats, would be, you know, Ron Paul's newsletters from the 90s, right? And which had these.
It's not from the 90s. This is like 40. This is like 40 years ago.
No, these were from the 90s. I think you've got the dates wrong on that. So you can check it out later. But anyway, so from certainly, 2008, more than 10 years prior to that. And so it's either decade or decades. The first thing they'd say is these, you know, racism. Basically, they cry racism as though Ron Paul's a racist. Now, he never wrote a racist thing in any of these. Somebody was managing his newsletter for him. He is a congressman, after all. He's busy, and he, you know, delivers babies in his spare time. And so he had a newsletter that had his name on it, and people would, you know, get the newsletter, and somebody wrote some stuff that was, I mean, not the most racist things that I've ever heard in my life, but not particularly pleasant either. And, you know, I mean, that would be the first sort of complaint in that realm. A lot of people accused at the time were accusing the editor, who was Lou Rockwell, of having written this stuff. Now, Lou would not address that at all. He would not say a thing. Turns out it wasn't Lou. It was some other guy. And, you know, whatever. You know, the guy was old and white and racist, whatever.
I have heard it is a rumor. I've heard another rumor, but I won't say it. Anyway, so I don't care. Like, I don't care if he did write them, and I don't care when they were written, because what his thoughts on a particular group of people. Now, first of all, I've read some of the things that they say are so racist, and I don't think that they are. I think they're racially charged. They're talking about black people behaving in a certain way, in a certain place, at a certain time. And you know what? It seemed like a pretty accurate description of what was happening when I read.
Racially charged is what I would call it. And I think it's just unhelpful to lump people together in categories that they certainly don't want to be lumped together in, right? Like, I don't want to be lumped together in with the white criminal category when that's not what I'm doing. So, you know, whatever.
So, in any case, this is something, yes, Democrats especially, they bring this up. Why? Because Democrats,
that's how politics
are,
is
race pimp psychopaths who obsess over these things, right? And you know what? We've got a bunch of leftists running around calling themselves libertarians who obsess over these things too, right?
Well, if they don't obsess over them, how are they going to bring people who communicate that way into the movement?
I don't want them to bring those people into the movement. Those people destroy everything that they get their hands on. And this is a problem, and I really think it's something that I want to get into economics with these people, because it's anti-capitalism. They're saying that you don't own your thoughts. We've got to control your freaking head.
Well,
It's every single time. They're not libertarians, okay? They're coming in here, and they're really obsessed with race and gender. Right? They're really obsessed with race and gender. And by the way, if you look at the economics that these lunatics are spewing over at Center for a Stateless Society, these people are anti-capitalist. They're saying free market, anti-capitalism, and they're throwing around this ridiculous word salad things. They're still leftists. They didn't become libertarians. They're just like, hey, I'm not a big fan of the government, but I still have the exact same agenda as when I was voting for Hillary Clinton.
Well, I think that the greater definition of a libertarian is basically somebody who thinks that the government is a poor solution to everything. And if you think that, then I suppose I'm willing to put you under the tent. If you're willing to look at whatever it is, as long as it's voluntary, I'm for it. Whatever your idea is that you want to get, you want women to be treated differently, or, you know, minorities to be treated differently, or whatever it is you want. And I think that there's probably some things that could be changed in those areas that would be positive for the society generally.
But these people generally tend to view, if you don't treat women the way they want you to, they view this as, they'll frequently call this microaggressions, right? Microaggressions. You're aggressing against people if you don't behave don't in the way that they want their mind control fantasy world to work.
Then they don't know what the definition of an aggression is.
They're lacking a lot of definitions. They tortured language, these people.
Well, that is the way to control the populace, is to some extent to control the language. There's no doubt about that. Your thoughts on it? 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off at checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
Attention listeners, SurvivalLife.com is giving away free EverStrike permanent matches for a limited time only. These matches are waterproof and will light in any weather condition, rain, snow, or sleet. It will still throw a spark. Its built-in ferro rod strikes at 3,000 degrees, and it is good for 15,000 strikes. Normally, $15. Today, it's free. Get yours at freesurvivalmatch.com. That's freesurvivalmatch.com. Hurry, supplies are limited. Visit freesurvivalmatch.com today.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission.
But I just
the
wanna...
Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the
I
Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brainworm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
It's 855-450-FREE. Those are the numbers you call to get on Free Talk Live. It's Free Talk Live. We're live if it's 7 to 10 p. Eastern time where you are and when you're hearing us. And it's a toll-free line, and you're able to call in and talk. 855-450-FREE. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
And you can actually use our listen or call us on Skype. LRN.FM is our username there. And we'd love to have you. You can go do your online shopping. When you do your online shopping, I want you to do it, please, if you will. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. It's an extra click, and I know nobody likes extra clicks on the internet. But when you do, you get the same prices, the same service you normally get, and Free Talk Live gets a little bonus. The fact is, you know, it's really helpful to us. Because when you have, like, say, one or two big advertisers, yeah, you know, when they drop off, that's a big hit. Yeah. What we want to do is we want to spread out the risk. And we spread out the risk by getting little bits here and there from everybody. And that's what happens when you do your shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. Spreads the risk out for us. Thanks so much. Shop.freetalklive.com. Let's go to nobody. Calling in from, I would assume, nowhere. Talking about, well, whatever. Nobody. Hey, you're on Free
possible.
Talk Live.
It's possible he might be somewhere.
Right. What's on your mind, nobody?
I just wanted to call and talk about some recent experiences, kind of trying to spread the ideas of, I guess, libertarianism, but really pointing out just the blatant, like, violence of. But I was talking to my.
I think he's cutting out pretty bad. We have packet loss there, it looks like.
Yep.
The can violence you- of what? The state?
Right.
So can real quick, can you encapsulate it as quickly as you can, nobody?
So I was talking to my sister. I was just kind of hanging out, and a bunch of police rolled through the neighborhood, and said something like just in passing. I was joking, scary, right? And I was just talking about the police being around, their presence being scary, and I pointed out that that the violent nature of it. And then we got into a conversation a little deeper, and I was saying, that's violence. I was saying, the things that they do, whether it be right or wrong, that's violence. And she just, she could not see it at all. She would not concede that point. She couldn't, like, she was having an identity crisis or something.
Were you pointing out that when they're acting, when police are acting as legitimate agents of people, like I can have an agent of force work for me. For instance, if I want to, protect myself from a dangerous person, I could hire Cantwell to walk around with me. And if a person acts dangerously towards me, Cantwell can do whatever is in within my rights to protect myself by being an agent of my rights. And he's accepting money for that. I think police do that all the time, that they're legitimate agents. Now, they, of course, are paid through tax money, which is extracted from people through threats of taking their liberty or their property away from them. That is, of course, violence.
Right. I was just making the point, by definition, the things that they're doing, it's coercion. It's either a threat of a violence and potentially actual violence. And I've taken up kind of points that y'all, speak about probably pretty frequently, and just, talking these points with people on the most basic level. And I didn't realize until recently that there is this, this disparity, like this discrepancy between definitions on this, the most fundamental level. It's ridiculous.
You really can't have a conversation unless you can get your definitions down. Cantwell and I were just having that go on in a couple of segments ago where we were discussing capitalism. Now, I agree with Cantwell's definition of capitalism and what it means, but a lot of people, they really don't know what capitalism means. It's been disparaged in their mind so often that I find the term to be, to some extent, not useful, because people are just activated by it, right? You have to meet them where they're at.
Inflammatory.
Yeah.
Right. And I think something huge.
This ain't going
to work. Towards,
I appreciate the call, you're dropping out. Thanks so much. 855-450-3733. Well,
so
sometimes Skype works out. What can I tell you?
Yeah, it doesn't look like I think the connection might be on our end tonight.
But I do. We can still continue to talk about the the Center for the Stateless Society and Students for Liberty. Interrupting Ron Paul. I think that's interesting. Ron Paul doesn't get interrupted too often. Lots of politicians deal with that kind of stuff on a pretty regular basis. So I guess, hey, Ron Paul's gotten a lot of slack in the past as far as not getting interrupted, so I think that's kind of interesting to me. Let's go to Daniel calling in Utah. Daniel, I pushed the wrong button. Can you believe that?
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, because I've done it before. Okay, so, Daniel, you can call back.
Wow.
I didn't mean to push that button.
Oh, well. Well, sorry, Daniel.
Ron Paul getting interrupted?
Yeah. And so, I don't know exactly where we left off here now, but the idea being, okay, he gets up there, he's making this this address, and he gets to a question and answer period. I mean, they're not just interrupting him in the middle of a speech, they're asking him a question, but they're not asking him a question. This is a staged event by rivals, right? These are ideological rivals who do not like who Ron Paul is or what Ron Paul stands for. These people want to do away, not just with Ron Paul, but with like the Ludwig von Mises Institute. Right, there's a bunch of anti-capitalists who are trying to label the Austrian economists as racist and misogynists for purposes other than their stated purpose. Do you understand where I'm getting at?
Oh, sure. People, this is politics, right?
Right.
But when people will use terms like racism and misogyny in order to, like, they make these big reaches, right? Like, if you believe in free markets, you're racist.
Right.
And they literally, people will literally say this. Now, I don't know. I don't know what lefties will, what you're, the folks you're talking about specifically, but I've heard people say this, and I'm like, what? You mean I want a system where a person has the ability to, you know, they have a fair opportunity to, you know, do things on their own. The government doesn't step in the way and prevent them from opening their business, depending on what neighborhood they're in or what their zoning rules are or whatever. I mean, governments have been used as tools of racism for as long as there have been governments and race. And that's a long darn time. Right. So you're telling me that I'm somehow racist because I believe people should have you know, opportunities? I don't think that that's the case. I find that very confusing. But some people will say that, and I find it confusing. So let's go to back to Daniel in Utah, who has called back, and I hope he'll accept my deepest apology. Daniel, you're on Free Talk Live.
Okay, yes. I think supply and demand is essential for the economy. But I think if you have monopoly economics, then capitalism is a form of communism.
Okay, run that by me again.
I think supply and demand is essential to have a sustainable economy. But I think when you have monopoly economics, then I think capitalism is a form of communism.
So okay, when was the last time you found an economy that didn't have supply and demand?
Well, if the government is manipulating everything, then that would be like complete communism.
Well, yeah, the government dominating the economy is usually how communism works.
But I mean, if there there's are free market supply
fanatics
and
out there who think that you're going to have you know, free market communism, and those people are not really worth very much taking seriously. Where did you study economics, sir?
I just been studying it through my life. I didn't like go to school to study it.
Well, where's this monopoly that we're talking about? That's what I find confusing, is monopolies generally don't exist without government coercion.
Well, correct. Well, yeah, it's people have to support a monopoly system where, like, the Federal Reserve can make up whatever it wants and, you know, bribe who it wants and corrupt the laws to maintain power.
That they do. Daniel, thank you for the call. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733, Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's
the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855 450 free. I guess we might be able to squeeze you in if you make that call right now. It's Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
Our AMP program. The AMP program is a program where you give us $5 a month and we give you commercial free podcasts and, you know, like the call in line and a really great amplifier forum on Facebook. And it's very active and lots of folks are involved there. And you're kind of inside Free Talk Live in many ways. But, you know, what it really is about, it's about spreading the ideas of liberty. So please, if you want to spread the ideas of liberty, Free Talk Live is a great way to do it. Just go to amp.freetalklive.com and, well, amp the program. We'd love to have you. So let's go to Sleepy Salsa calling in here, trying to figure out how to answer this call. I don't know what to do. Okay. There you go. Sleepy okay. Salsa, you're on Free Talk Live.
Howdy from Texas. I believe Chris Cantwell mentioned a moment ago, if I heard him correctly, something about Students for Liberty.
Yeah.
And, you know, I read your article recently about the antic that they, the stunt they pulled in D.C. And just the two things I wanted to say is, first, please don't quit. You know, a lot of us, you know, like you down here.
Thank you.
The second thing, sure. And the second thing is that I was thinking more about what you wrote, and I was trying to look back into it more because
ChristopherCantwell.com.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The title of the article is Against Second Wave Libertarianism.
Great title, by the way. And I was asking, you know, both my I've had requests from both the Patriot faction as well as the preppers and just different types of friendly political factions, just different people I know asked me to look more into what you were writing. And I did. And it's this very weird web, something about Russia and the Ukraine. It doesn't really matter too much because it really only matters what happens here in the States as far as our lives go. And I find it very interesting that Students for Liberty seem to want to be very politically correct, as it were, and somehow use that against Ron Paul. And the weird thing, Chris, is that if someone wanted to go after Ron Paul, there are plenty of bad things that he actually did, like going to the WIPO, for instance, a couple years back, the RonPaul.com copyright scandal. But This was not a real thing they did. It's playing politics.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the part of the problem. Look, I mean, you know, some of these people who came after Ron Paul would tell you that they are anarchists. And if they are anarchists and they believe in non-aggression, then there are things that you can go after Ron Paul for. Like, I don't know, collecting a congressional salary and for voting for the authorization for use of military force against Afghanistan and for going to the WIPO again, like you said, over ronpaul.com. For
what
threatening
is the WIPO?
This is the World Intellectual Property. He went to the UN to try to get ronpaul.com wrestled away from the people who own it.
It's true.
And these are things, these are really good reasons to criticize Ron Paul and say, hey, Ron Paul, why are you going and doing these things? And, you know, then you can get Ron Paul's answer on them and you can have an actual discussion about it. Instead, these people go after him on race and gender and sexuality, which is a nonsense, completely nonsense argument that has nothing to do with libertarianism, because they are trying to change libertarianism. I think they want to redefine libertarianism as, I don't know, like drug-induced homosexual anti-capitalism is what these people really want to turn it into. And I don't think that these people have any place in anything resembling my idea of libertarianism, because they're running around there. That's the guy who's wearing a sign, if you meet the Rothbard on the road, kill him.
What the hell does that mean?
It's a play on a Buddhist quote, which is basically if you see the Buddha, kill him. Which is if you believe that you've found enlightenment, then kill that image and move on, because you're never going to know it. And the idea being, oh well, if you see the Rothbard on the road, kill him. Meaning there is no definition of libertarianism. It's reality is an impermanent delusion, is the idea behind it. These people literally just don't even believe in an objective reality. That's why they change the meaning of words, and they don't.
Wouldn't libertarianism, by its sort of its definition, and I understand that you can be a libertarian and not necessarily believe that you know, the government shouldn't be involved in everything, but basically libertarianism, as its definition is that there's no state, right? Like there should be no monopoly on the use of violence in a given landmass or whatever, and that if you know, that's really what it comes down to.
It's non-initiation of force in my book and in Rothbard's. But the other thing is that when you're getting into non-initiation of force, you have to consider that, like, if you believe in different rules on property, well, then the rules on force get dramatically different very rapidly, right? Like a guy called in about absentee ownership. Well, you know, Mark, if you go to Acapulco and somebody decides that because you went to Acapulco, the rules of property say they can move into your house and start eating your food, right? Then you come home and they say, well, my rules of property say that I can do this. And you say, well, my rules of property say you can't. And I'm calling Cantwell to come over here with his gun. Well, now we're going to have a problem, right? So these people have really whacked out ideas on what property is and what aggression is, and they're running around calling themselves libertarians and saying, well, I believe in non-aggression, so I'm a libertarian.
I wish they'd call in. I really wish that I could have these conversations. Like, Free Talk Live, to some extent, when I got involved, my idea was is that we were going to have a forum for liberty-oriented people to have conversations about the things that we, you know, really parse out issues. And frankly, that doesn't happen. Well, I mean, you know, we don't have people who, you know, believe or disbelieve these things calling in very often. We had, earlier this evening, we had some guy who believed in conspiracy theories. Like, we had a couple of them talking about chemtrails or whatever, and that's fine by me. But I would have really loved to have had a conversation with these people. But instead, they want to interrupt the Ron Paul, speech or whatever, and that's fine. But
because their goal is not to have a rational discussion. If they wanted to have a rational discussion, they wouldn't be screaming about race and gender. They wouldn't be doing that. They wouldn't be calling people racist if they wanted to have a discussion about anything. That's not what somebody who has a point to make does. Somebody who has a point to make makes a point instead of interrupting respectable figures while they're trying to address a group of interested people and hurling baseless epithets at them.
Yeah, I would encourage them to call in to Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE tomorrow, and let's talk about these ideas. What are we talking about here? Because I don't really understand or know. I've read a few things from the c4ss.org website, and you know, some of it I've liked, and some of it hasn't really done anything for me.
The guy Kevin Carson wrote an article, "The End of Libertarians," where he's talking about what happened at the Students for Liberty thing, right? Okay. So it's c4ss. Kevin Carson writes about this thing, and he's like, we need to grow beyond this, and we need to grow the movement, and da-da-da-da-da. Well, when you go look at Kevin Carson's author profile, Kevin Carson's author profile contains titles like Venture Communism, The Communism of Everyday Life.
You can grow the movement by allowing, by just basically destroying the definition of libertarianism.
Well, exactly. They're opponents of libertarianism. They are they're the enemy.
I don't know. I mean, I don't really know. I've talked to a few folks like this. It seems like we agree on the large
Center for a Stateless Society, by the way, founded by confessed child rapist Brad Spangler.
Well, does it matter who's founded it?
Yeah, I do. I think it matters a lot. Also, who else was involved with that thing? It was Stacey Litz, that girl who was selling drugs with her pals, and then she got caught and threw all her friends under the bus because they're a bunch of irresponsible leftists.
That was a big scandal. Sleepy Souls, do you have anything else?
Yeah, sure. Just for Chris, I mean, maybe a potential article idea, maybe something like faux grievances. You know, people who like to hurl the baseless epithets, as you put it. And claim, tree hugging or whatever else, right? But like grievances that are not actually substantive, and they try to use it as a political talking point. And having said that, thanks for taking my call.
Thank you, buddy.
Thanks, Sleepy Salsa, calling in from Texas. Go right ahead on this C4SS thing.
Okay, so these people, look, the left is the political ideology of the irresponsible. Okay, that's why they want that's why their statist counterparts want to redistribute the wealth, right? They want to take from the rich and give to the poor, and then the definition of rich and poor keeps on changing.
Well, what about when let's talk about say England prior to the crown giving up control in the early 1900s. At that point, you had essentially the wealthy, the privileged, owned all the land, and then the poor folks were living on their land, paying them rent in many cases to live there. I mean, don't you think it's possible for wealth to be to sit in too few hands, and then something besides sort of the free market needs to kick in to redistribute, because something besides the free market certainly was kicked in for so long that the redistribution to the rich needed to be counteracted?
If you've got somebody who you could say got something from you by illicit means, then fine, then go after them and take it. But to say that because they have it, because they are rich, because they gained something, that they necessarily did something wrong, that's a whole other world, and that's very, very dangerous thought process. I can't abide it.
Check us out in the meantime at facebook.freetalklive.com and at freetalklive.com. You can participate on the website. It's been Mark with you.
And Cantwell.
855. What am I giving you? No, freetalklive.com. That's what I want to say. Good night.
Email is easy, instant, and free, and that can be real embarrassing. Email lacks the eye contact and body language you get in face-to-face conversation, or the tone of voice and other nuance you hear in a telephone conversation. Email is just words, often few words. We're all smothering in spam, so we often reply in terse fashion that's easy to misunderstand. And email doesn't cost you a postage stamp, and it lacks the deliberation time it'd take to walk to the snail mailbox, so it's easy to succumb to the "oh yeah" stimulus response trap. When in doubt, don't snap back at snippy messages you get. You may have mistaken the sender's intent, and unless you're sending AOL to AOL, there's no unsend. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,206, down $3. Silver opened at $16.53, down 11 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $238. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? For a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss this unique opportunity. To sign up and get your 1 month cost-free advertising gift, just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. In the news, an investigation by The Guardian has revealed the Chicago Police Department has been using a warehouse as a black site to illegally hold suspects without access to family, attorneys, and where they're subject to beatings. The facility is located in Chicago's Holman Square and has been used as a workstation for special police units. The Guardian interviewed lawyers and former detainees who revealed several facts, including detainees being kept out of official arrest databases, shackled for extended periods of time, and denied access to attorneys for 12 to 24 hours. Some suspects were as young as 15 years old. One man was found unresponsive while at the facility's interview room. He later died. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, each day this week, the Liberty Beat is bringing you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. Here's John Bush.
Own firearms and know how to use them safely and proficiently. Purchase a shotgun and handgun and learn to use them in defense of your home. Acquire a rifle and learn to shoot with accuracy in defense of your family and property. It helps to learn from a friend or family member or take a course in self-defense and firearm safety. Firearms are a very serious tool as they have the ability to take a person's life. Always practice the four firearm safety rules. Number one, always act as if your weapon is loaded. Number two, be aware of your target and what lies behind your target. Number three, always keep your finger off the trigger until you are ready to fire. Number four, only point your firearm at something you are willing to destroy.
The Liberty Beat is sponsored by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. That's CoinArch.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, February 25th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. A new study published in the BMJ's Journal of Epidemiology and Community Health has confirmed fluoride's effect on the thyroid gland and a possible connection to depression. The research comes from the University of Kent in England, which examined thyroid activity for those in areas with fluoridated water and those without. The researchers found high rates of underactive thyroid were 30% more likely in areas with high fluoride concentration. An underactive thyroid can lead to depression, weight gain,